Welcome back to ATVN. Baseball legend and Fox Sports analyst Alex Rodriguez visited USC Annenberg School for Communication and Journalism this afternoon for a conversation with director Willow Bay. Dozens of students and faculty came out to hear the three-time AL MVP talk about his 22-year playing career and what lies ahead. Annenberg Media's Connor McGlynn sat down with Rodriguez to talk about his new role as a mentor in the Yankee organization.
I'm very flattered and humbled that Hal Steinbrenner has me as one of his advisors, and the fact that I have an opportunity to mentor some of our great young players is something that I'm very happy about and I take extremely seriously. And you know, for me playing almost 23 years, Connor, I feel like I'm in a very unique position to be able to go back and talk to our players about the good, the bad, and the ugly, and really talk to them about that arc. And hopefully they can learn from some of my great mistakes, but also they can learn about some of the great things that I've done in the game.
For more on our exclusive one-on-one with A-Rod, check out uscannenbergmedia.com. The USC men's baseball team is set to play in the Dodgertown Classic this weekend. Sports correspondent Angel Viscara caught up with outfielder Lars Nootbaar to discuss the season thus far and what lies ahead for the team.
Thanks, Julia. Well, I'm here at Dado Field, joined by hot-hitting USC outfielder Lars Nootbaar, whose strong performances at the plate so far have been one of the many reasons that the Trojans have gotten off to the 6-2 start they have. Lars, how are things going down here at Dado? How's the team feeling through 8 games?
You know, through 8 games, we're 6-2, like you said, and you know, we're feeling pretty good. You know, 8-0 obviously would have been the goal, but we'll take 6-2. A split over in North Carolina wasn't bad, wasn't great. So I mean, you know, team camaraderie is at an all-time high right now, so we're pretty excited.
And through these first 8 games, it really feels like you guys are doing a great job of getting the ball on the bat. You're first in the conference in home runs early on, second in runs scored. Really, what do you attribute the success at the dish to?
I mean, a lot of it has to go, you know, to our mental approach to the plate, and you know, our physical and mental approach goes to our coaches, you know, Matt Curtis and Gabe Alvarez. They've really been helping us out at the plate, you know, spending their time in the cages, and whenever we need help, you know, we can ask them any questions we do. And so, yeah, you know, our coaches definitely have been helping us out a lot this year.
All right, and you're an El Segundo native. I've got to ask, do you bleed Dodger blue or are you an Angel guy?
I bleed Dodger blue, that's for sure, yeah.
All right, so you must be excited about the Dodgertown Classic this weekend.
Yeah, I'm very excited about Dodgertown Classic. Last year, being able to play in that was a dream come true for me, so can't wait for that to happen again.
And you're going to play some big-time matchups, starting off with San Diego, Michigan, then wrapping it up with UCLA on Sunday. Any of those matchups really stand out to you? You excited about?
I mean, UCLA every year. UCLA at Dodger Stadium. You know, last year we had a grinder. I think went to 13 innings, and unfortunately we came out on the short end. But this year we're excited for some comeback. So, you know, Sunday's going to be a fun one.
Awesome. Well, we'll be looking forward to it. That's all the time we have here at Dado with Lars. We send it back to you, the studio, now.
Thanks, Angel. Now from the diamond to the court, the USC men's basketball team is approaching its final games of the regular season this week against Washington State tonight and Washington on Saturday. USC has lost 4 consecutive games for the first time this season. However, the Trojans did crush both the Cougars and the Huskies earlier this year.
Getting in the gym, we're going hard. We're focusing on the game plan, and we just got to go out there and execute. We're not worried about Vegas right now. We're just going to take it game by game. We just focus on Washington State.
At 21-8 overall and 8-8 in the Pac-12, the Trojans remain on track to end up on the right side of the NCAA tournament bubble, as long as they start winning again. The NFL Combine kicks off today. 8 Trojans have joined the roster of 330 potential NFL players suiting up to impress NFL teams, and some of them are taking to social media to profile their journeys at the Combine. After announcing he was entering that draft on his Twitter account, wide receiver Juju Smith-Schuster has avidly posted Instagrams of him training. After arriving to Indianapolis yesterday, he posted this photo captioned, "Been a long road and put a lot into this. The time is now. Thank you to everyone who supported me to this point." Another USC player who left early, Adoree Jackson, tweeted this message to his followers in advance of the combine, saying, "Some people will never support you because they're afraid of what you might become." Offensive tackle Zach Banner was also active on Twitter, quote tweeting a post from the NFL with the caption, "Opportunity of a lifetime. Let's get it." The combine runs until Monday, so be sure to keep up with these Trojan social media accounts for updates. Kaylee and Rachel, back to you guys.